I'd like to introduce you to two remarkable people, Benjamin Paul and Delphine Duclos. Ben and Delphine were speakers of a small Native American language called Chitimacha, spoken in the bayous of Louisiana, and they were its last two speakers. I want you to imagine for a moment what that's like, to be the last speaker of your language, knowing that when you pass away, your language will fall silent. My research aims to document languages like Chitimacha before they disappear. These endangered languages, or languages that are no longer being learned by the youth, have some of the most fascinating things to tell us about the nature and history of language. Take Chitimacha, for example. It's a language isolate, which means it's completely unrelated to any language we know of. It's unique, and it's a rich, expressive language with all sorts of cool things like the verb nitgesht, to dump up or pour a soft mass into liquid. And that k sound you hear is what's called an ejective consonant, and Chitimacha is the only language in the Southeast to have those types of sounds. The language is also very sensitive to position, so that you can't just say, I am reading, but instead you have to say things like, I am sitting reading, I am standing reading, or I am lying down reading. Okay, so now I'm a linguist, I think this kind of stuff is pretty cool, but what's really interesting is that all of the languages in the Southeast show the same sit-stand-lie pattern. And keep in mind, these languages are unrelated to Chitimacha. So this suggests that what happened is that Chitimacha borrowed the sit-stand-lie pattern without actually borrowing the words for sit-stand and lie. And that tells us something really important about the history of contact between the languages and peoples in that region. So endangered languages like Chitimacha have a lot to teach us. Now, you might be asking, how do we even know this about Chitimacha if the language isn't spoken anymore? Well, in the 1930s, a graduate student in linguistics, like myself, named Morris Swadesh, went to Louisiana and recorded hundreds of pages of words, sentences, and stories in the language. And then those materials sat in an archive for 70 years, untouched and unknown to the tribe who thought their language was gone. And in the 1990s, those materials were rediscovered, and along with them, this. Wax cylinder recordings of Ben and Delphine speaking Chitimacha in 1932. This sparked a linguistic renaissance in the community. And in 2008, I began working with the tribe to produce a dictionary, pedagogical materials for the classroom, and even the award-winning Rosetta Stone software for the language. And this is the other facet of my linguistic research, is to make the outputs of my linguistic analysis accessible to communities trying to revitalize their language. And for the Chitimacha, it's working. For the first time in 70 years, you can hear the language being spoken at school, at home, and out in the communities. A true renaissance on the bayou. Thank you very much.